three machine scheduling problem. So this is the problem. You are given the following data regarding the processing times of some jobs on three machines, machine 1, machine 2 and machine 3. So here we have some jobs and three machines and processing times. The order of processing is 1, 2 and 3. Here we have to process the jobs according to the order of the machines, that is machine 1 and machine 2 and machine 3. Determine the sequence that minimizes the total elapsed time required to complete the jobs. To process all these jobs, we have to determine a optimum sequence, and that should be minimizes the total elapsed time. So we have to determine the optimum sequence. Also evaluate total elapsed time and the idle time of machine 2 and machine 3. Right. For determining the optimum sequence, so what we have to do? In two machine scheduling, we have two jobs, we have two machines. With the help of given processing times, we just determined the optimum sequence. For determining the optimum sequence for three machines, it is somewhat difficult comparing with the two machine scheduling. So for calculating the optimum sequence, we required only two machines, two processing times and two machines we need. But here in three machine scheduling, we have three machines. So what we have to do is we have to convert these three machines into two machines. Then we can easily find out the optimum sequence like two machine scheduling. So how we have to make these three machines into two machines? Converting three machines into two machines, then we can easily determine the optimum sequence. So for that, we need to apply the Johnson's rule. The Johnson's rule we have to apply for making three machines into two machines. So how we have to apply the Johnson's rule? First, let us understand what is Johnson's rule. So according to the Johnson's rule, we have two steps. With the help of these two steps, we can make three machines into two machines. Then we can easily make the optimum sequence. So in step one, we have two conditions. In these two conditions, any one of condition will become true. Then we go for step two. If both conditions will become false, then we no need to apply this Johnson's rule to make three machines into two machines. Then in that situation, we have to follow CD's method. Right. So let us check these two conditions in step one. Any one of condition will become satisfied or not. So let us check the condition number one in the step one. So what is the condition number one? So here, minimum of machine one is greater than or is equal to maximum of machine two of processing times here. So what we have to take here? The processing times we have to take. So minimum of machine one processing times. So where is machine 1 processing times. So here we have machine 1 processing times. So what we need here? Minimum of machine 1 processing time. So what is the minimum processing time here for machine 1? So here we have 3 is the minimum processing time value. So that minimum value we have to take here. So 3 is greater than or is equals to, and next what we have to take? Maximum of machine 2 processing time. So this is the machine 2. So machine 2 processing time. So maximum of machine 2 processing time we have to take. So in these processing times, so the maximum processing time is, that is 5. So here 3 is greater than or is equals to 5. So is this true or is this false? So the condition 1 will become false. If we apply these processing times into condition 1, so definitely we will get false. The condition will become false, right? So let us go for check the condition number 2. Is it will become satisfied or not? Right. So minimum of machine 3 processing times. So here we have machine 3 processing times. So in these processing times, we have to take which is the minimum processing time. So here we have the minimum processing time is 5. So here we have to take the 5 processing time is greater than or is equals to maximum of machine 2. So machine 2 processing times are here. So in these processing times, the maximum processing time is 5 again. So here we can take 5 here. So let us check, is it condition true? So 5 is greater than or is equals to 5. Of course 5 is not greater than 5, but it is equals to 5. So the machine 3 minimum value of machine 3, it should be maximum of machine 2, or it should be is equals to maximum of machine 2 value. So both values are same. That means 5 is equals to 5. 5 is not greater than 5, but 5 is equals to 5. So here simply the condition is true, right? So in step 1, what we have to do? So we have to apply these two conditions to the problem. So finally here we got that means the condition number 2 will become true. So any one of the condition will become true to apply Johnson's rule. If the two conditions will become true, then no problem. Any one of the condition will become true, also no problem. We can apply the Johnson's rule. Okay, so here one condition will become true, then we can easily apply this Johnson's rule to make 3 machines into 2 machines to find out the optimum sequence. Right, so this is the step 1. Okay, step 1 is okay. Then we go for step 2. So what we have to do in the step 2, we have to make 2 imaginary machines. We have to make 2 imaginary machines, whatever the names are. So I just have given G and H. So 2 imaginary machines we have to create. So here for G machine, so we have to add all the processing times of machine 1 and machine 2. For H machine, so we have to add machine 2 and machine 3 processing times. Right. So here for G machine, so we have to add what? Machine 1 and machine 2 processing time. So here machine 1 and machine 2 processing times we have to add here. So for job A, 3 plus 4. So machine 1 3, machine 2 is 4. So 3 plus 4, these two values we have to add and we have to write here. So that is 7. And likewise, so we have to add all these values. 8 plus 3, 11. And next, 7 plus 2, 9. And next for D job, 4 plus 5. Again, 9 we will get here. For E job, 9 plus 1, 10. And 8 plus 4, 12. For G job, 7 plus 3, 10. So this is the imaginary machine. I added the two machine processing times into one processing time. Right? Right. Let us go for H machine. So here what we have to add for the machine 2 processing times and machine 3 processing times we have to add. So machine 2 processing times we have to add and with machine 3, right? So here 4 plus 6, 10. So likewise, we have to calculate all the processing times here for imaginary machines. Okay, 2 plus 5, 7. 5 plus 11, 16. The next, 5 plus 1, 6. For F job, 4 plus 6, 10. And next, 3 plus 12, 15. Right. So we made three machines into two imaginary machines. And we have two imaginary machine processing times. Now it is very easy to determine the optimum sequence. Like two machine scheduling problem, we can easily determine the optimum sequence now. We just applied the Johnson's rule when the step 1 becomes true and we made two imaginary machines, right? So we can easily determine the optimum sequence now, right? So for determining the optimum sequence, so we have to compare all the processing times. So in these processing times, so we have to take, so which is the lowest processing time here we have? So 7 we have, 6 we have, okay? So 6 is the lowest processing time. So this processing time is relating to the H machine and D job. So in the optimum sequence, we have to place the job D. So where we have to, this is job E. So where we have to place the job here? So 6 is the lowest processing time. So we have to place the job from right to left in the optimum sequence. From right to left, we have to place here. Because it is relating to the H machine and we are going to place the E here, E job here. Okay, because this is the lowest processing time. Just so I just applied I just want to apply a color. So after that, what are the other lowest processing time? So we have to compare the other processing times and we have to find out the lowest processing time. Okay, so after 6 we have 7 here. So there are two 7s we have. So which one we have to take? So which job we have to place in the optimum sequence? Okay, so here which one we have to take? So for that we have to compare the corresponding processing times. So for this 7 processing time, so we have these 9 corresponding processing time we have. For this 7 we have 10 processing time. Okay, so we have to compare these two processing times, processing corresponding times. So comparing these two, so which is lowest value, again we have to check. And whatever the lowest value we have, so that processing time we have to take. Okay, so here 9 corresponding value is very less comparing to the other corresponding processing time. right? So here we have to take this 7 and we have to place this C job in the optimum sequence, right? So this 7 processing time is relating to the H machine. So we have to place this C job from right to left. From right to left we have to place, because this is the 7 processing time is relating to the H machine. Okay, the second machine, right? Whatever the machine name is, okay? Right, so I have taken the C machine in the optimum sequence. So we no need to place again it in the optimum sequence. So already we know what is the lowest processing time we have. So here one more 7 we have. So here we have to place the A job in the optimum sequence. So here, so A job here we have. So this is relating to the G machine. So we have to place the A job from left to right. Okay. I just want to apply a color. Okay. So after 7, so what is the lowest processing time we have? So after 7, we have the lowest processing time, that is after 7 we have 9 here. 9. So this 9, that means we have to place the D job on optimum in the optimum sequence. So this is regarding to the G machine. So that's why we have to place from left to right in the optimum sequence. Okay. Then I play color, because we no need to place the job in the optimum sequence. Okay. So after 9, so we have the lowest processing time is 10. Here we have 10, here we have 10, here also we have 10. So 10 is the lowest processing time now. So we have 3 tens. So which one we have to choose? Which 10 we have to choose? Simply we have to compare the corresponding values and we have to select the processing time. So here we have 11, here we have 12, here we have 15. So 11 is the lowest processing time. So this 10 we have to take. Okay, so this 10 we have to take, and we have to place the B job. We have to place the B job from right to left. Okay, then after that, here we have 12, we have 15, we have. So what is the lowest processing lowest corresponding processing time? 12. So we have to take this 10. Okay, so this is also regarding to the H machine, and we have to place the F job in the optimum sequence. So we have to place the job from right to left. Okay, so finally we have only 110. So this is regarding to the G machine and G job. Okay, so from left to right we have to place the G job. So finally we have only one job, we can simply place in the optimum sequence, no problem. Okay, so likewise, like two machine scheduling, we can easily determine the optimum sequence. Okay, so first what we have to do, so we have to make 3 machines into 2 machines, 2 machine processing times, then only we can easily determine the optimum sequence. With the help of 3 machines we cannot determine the optimum sequence. So with applying Johnson's rule, if the step 1 will become true or any one of condition will become true, then we can make 2 imaginary machines, and with the help of the 2 imaginary machines and processing times we can easily make the optimum sequence, right? So after determining the optimum sequence, then we have to process the jobs. So this is the optimum sequence. With the help of Johnson's rule, we can easily find out the optimum sequence.